kangaroo. Oh, gori gori, oh, bakke chori, chahe roz bula ya karo. Oh, gori gori, oh, bakke chori, kabhi meri gali aaya karo. Oh, gori gori, oh, bakke chori, chahe roz bula ya karo.
Yes, isn't that super
cool? Rose, rose,
the wild and remote county of Donegal, surely one of Ireland's most rugged and unspoiled regions. Over 400 years ago, the remnants of a defeated Spanish armada limped along this shoreline, but these days, you'll find nothing more dangerous than a trawler. Today I'm introducing Kamal to rock fishing for pollack, and it's so remote here that if we don't catch anything, we'll be eating baked beans for tea.
Stopping here at Kamal, we're actually taking a walk for about half a mile.
Oh, lovely. Of course.
Long old walk.
Okay.
Do you want to get the bag? I'll take the rug.
Yeah.
Got everything?
Is the bike going to be okay here?
Yeah, it'll be fine. Oh, nobody will touch it. Now, this is Ireland.
That is true. What are we going to catch here today?
Pollack.
Pollack.
Can you cook pollack?
Pollack is like cod. Or pollack. Is it like cod, isn't it?
Kamal, what's these cows here? Just walk very carefully here because if you make any sudden movements, they'll charge.
And I'm holding this red bag.
Come on, just be careful now. Careful.
Are you serious?
Yeah. No, you just want to go very slowly.
Yeah, you can hold that bag then. Give me that green one. Maybe that's a green light.
Green.
Green
just
light.
Cows, they'll not touch you.
I'm telling you. You're holding me too
hard. Oh, gori gori, oh, bakke chori, kabhi meri gali aaya karo. Oh, gori gori, oh, bakke chori, chahe roz bulaya karo. Roz, roz bulaya
karo. That looks very rough.
It is.
I don't think we're going to be able to fish. I'll tell you what, let's get down and take a look.
We leave the bags here, should we?
Yeah.
Look at that wave.
Not a chance, Kamal.
It's very rough.
Yeah, it's far too rough. I'm afraid we're going to have to go about half a mile up that way. We'll get some sheltered water.
But are you sure we're going to catch some fish there?
Oh yeah, we'll catch there. We'll catch there.
Okay.
Tell you what though, there's a lot more to see here. Look at that.
Oh,
there's a huge one coming
whoa,
in.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Look. Look at that.
It's coming right towards me.
Let's go, mate. When you get them, lift, and you've got them, shout like mad. I got one. These fish are pollack.
Right.
And they're going to pull like mad. If you catch a big one.
Are they
one,
big or the small fish?
Yeah, you can catch them about this size, but you can catch some, if we're lucky,
right,
this size. Be too big for the
so
pan.
We just need one if we catch that size?
Yeah, but I want to catch one too.
Okay, we catch two.
So listen, I would suggest you cast straight out there. There's a big deep channel in here. And the pollack come right in here for food.
Right.
And if they're in there, you'll catch one pretty quickly. So if you just drop it in there, let it sink down about 7 feet.
And how do you spin it? I mean,
you put your hand on there, always two fingers each side.
Yes.
And you lift the line with your first finger.
Yes.
And then open the bail arm. This is the bail arm.
Yes.
And then swing the rod and throw it all out.
Now, which way do I swing it?
Well, you can swing it this way.
Either
or
way.
This way.
Either way. Okay.
Whichever's comfortable, but let go of the line at the right moment. And
right.
When you let go of the line there, now what'll happen? You let go, it all goes like that.
Yes.
It all falls off.
What kind of fishing are you doing, Alan?
It's called fly fishing. People normally use it for trout because trout eat flies. So there's no weight on the line, there's just a little fly tied on the end. But I'm using it for pollack. I suppose everybody uses it now for lots of different species of fish. I think by the time we're finished today, Kamal, we're not going to have any supper.
Yeah?
Tell you what, we
catch fish for my living.
Yeah, we've got to catch fish for our dinner tonight. Break a leg here, handy Kamal.
You wouldn't need.
You're right. That looks a lot better now. You see the swell's gone right down.
Yeah.
Think the tide's turned and it's going out, and that helps.
You think we'll catch some fish here?
I think we're in business, pal.
Well, I hope so. There's one thing for sure, Alan. At the end of this holiday, I'll be a fisherman.
You're doing very well, Kamal.
Yeah. I enjoy it now. Oh yes, I got one! Yes! We're in!
It's not a very big one, I'm afraid, Kamal. But two mouthfuls worth.
Well, that's only a wee tiny thing.
Yeah.
This lovely colour.
Fabulous. Bronzy, coppery colour. And then he's got this lovely sort of camouflage effect. He's dark on top, you can't see him from above, light on the bottom, so you can't see him from below. Big eyes for deep water.
Yes.
There's enough in there for one person at least.
Me.
One pollock.
Well, of course. Well, as long as I get something to eat.
Well,
okay.
If I catch one more, and if I catch two more, we'll eat well. If I catch one more, we'll at least eat.
Okay.
So there you are. Look at that. Dolphins. See them?
There's so many of them.
Oh, they've just come around the point. Oh, that was absolutely fantastic, Kamal. That's the best thing I've...
I can't believe you've done that.
tell you what, I'm jolly glad I did it.
I can't believe you've done that.
And you nearly talked me out of it.
I still don't believe you've done that.
Do you know they're so big in the water?
Yeah.
And do you know when you're out there, you actually feel quite vulnerable? So you've got these massive great things, you can see them swimming right under you. Two of them came out to check me out first. There was a baby there, did you see it? You can just see him out there if you watch now. You can see him. Small one, here he comes. Well, Kamal, I'm afraid they're small. There he goes.
Well, just say that's when you go.
That's him. Beautiful. Goodbye. Yeah. I was fishing off this pier with these kids. And they caught nothing all day. And I walked down with my fly rod and I caught this pollack. And they said to me, how did you do that? And I says, well, it's simple. What you gotta do is do what Bert and Ernie do. You know who Bert and Ernie are?
Oh.
Bert and Ernie are at Sesame Street. And they went fishing one day and Ernie was showing Bert how to fish and he said, here, fishy, fishy, fishy. And then he caught a fish. So I told the kids this and I went, here, fishy, fishy. And I caught a fish as soon as I said it. So if you say...
But it is so handy. I mean, I can't understand how you can catch the fish without a bait.
Just say, here, fishy, fishy. Cast out.
After I throw this down and say, fishy, fishy, fishy.
That's it. No, here, fishy, fishy, fishy.
Here, fishy, fishy, fishy.
That's right. Three times.
Come, I, cookie, cookie, cookie. Here, fishy, fishy, fishy. Oh, I missed one.
Oh, I got one.
You've got the pollack.
I got one. Da, 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 da. Oh, whoa.
It is a fish.
You got one. I told you. Here, fishy, fishy. And it worked first time.
Look it in. Oh, it's a beauty, Kamal. That's a beauty. Well done, sir.
Ha-ha.
See, you should listen to your
That's
Uncle Alan all the time.
Can we take this and cook it?
He'll do us for our tea, absolutely.
Yes.
Isn't that super?
Yes, we keep it.
And isn't it absolutely right? Here, fishy, fishy.
Okay, I do that again.
Tell me if it was the truth.
Ah, it was. Definitely.
First time you said it.
Okay, I'll say the same again.
Oh, look, it doesn't count. He's foul hooked.
So?
You see, he's not hooked in the mouth.
What does that mean?
That means you haven't really caught him. We have to put him back in.
No, you can't do that. We need our dinner.
I'm starving.
Oh, we'll keep it.
We'll keep it?
Yes, we'll keep it.
Oh yes, oh it is a good one! Oh look at that goat!
Come on, look at this! I got a good one!
Come on! Can you bring the net? It's sitting up the top! Bring the net!
Marvelous!
Sweetie!
And my trousers changed.
Look at that, Kamal.
What a size of fish!
Isn't that magnificent, eh?
My goodness.
When you catch a big, powerful guy like that, it just feels like you've got a flipping torpedo on the end.
Hey, what a fight they put up, eh? On a fly rod, especially. Look at that, isn't that superb,
lovely.
Kamal? Hey, a beauty, look at that.
That's a pollack.
What are you going to do for cooking?
I don't know. I want to see what kind of fillet you get out of it.
Well, there you go. That's a nice white
one. That's a small one, isn't it?
That's a small one. And of course, that.
And will you take the skin off it?
I'll take the skin off for you.
So what we will do is we'll make pakoras. We'll make fried fish or fish pakoras first.
Pollock pakoras.
Yeah. Pakoras, and then what we'll do is we'll make something else, maybe curry. Because I've got rice and all, we'll make some rice today.
Would you like boiled rice or pilau rice?
Pilau rice coming up.
Lovely slab,
that's
eh?
That's plenty, but we'll need to wash it again.
I've just given it a real good scrub.
Can you smell the cumin seeds in this?
What are you doing?
I'm making pilau rice. What I've done is I've put in cumin seeds, cardamom pods, and I'm also going to put some... There is cinnamon stick in there, onions, one star and a seed. Smell that. Smell that. That is star aniseed.
Mm.
Gives a lovely flavour.
Is that what aniseed seeds actually grow in?
No, small aniseeds. See those? These are aniseeds there.
But are they out of a pod? Like that? No, they're obviously they're not.
No. This is, you can have that on its own. Eat it just like that.
Mm-hmm.
You can try it, but it's very strong. Do you like lots of chilies? In the rice, just tiny bit.
Well, sure, as we've had such a hot day in every sense of the word.
Aye, but you know,
put another spoon
hot cup of tea on a hot day.
No, great stuff.
Same thing with the chilies or the hot food. Can you pass me that rice, please, Alan?
Aren't you going to put this boy? Shall I set him up for you?
Yes, please, because we are going to make fish in that. I think I put too much rice in there, but it'll turn out all right.
This one broken? No.
No, it shouldn't be. Well, could you just throw this because it'll not fit a... Well, what the hell?
That's a lot of stuff in pilau rice. I mean, pilau rice is...
Pilau rice, but it'll turn out really nice.
Is that pilau rice without the peas?
Yes. Well, we're hardly going to make some peas around here.
No frozen peas at
no
all,
No frozen peas, yeah. Alan, what we're going to do is, we're going to make some pakoras. Can you pass me some gram flour? This tiny bit of gram.
What exactly is gram flour?
Chickpea flour.
Oh, so it's not flour at all?
No. It is chickpea flour.
Chickpeas, isn't that what they make falafels out of?
I wouldn't have a clue because we make all the pakoras with it. This is kind of a batter. We make a batter out of it.
So that's chickpea flour?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So what we'll do is we'll just throw a bit of...
Salt and curry, chili powder.
Yeah. Cumin seeds. This fish is quite flaky. Give me an egg. There is eggs in one of those bags. In that green bag.
In the green bag. Eggs. Ah, yes.
Just give me one egg. Actually, if you want to give me some more water, but don't pour any till I tell you to. Oops.
and you're a bit wobbly.
This egg is going to seal the fish so it will not flick. You see? What I'm going to do is, that is the way it's going to be.
Ah.
So it'll be all sealed. That's plenty for us for a starter, wouldn't it?
Are you making a starter and a main course then?
Yeah. We'll make a nice curry or a masala fish out of it.
And are you going to fry it?
No, I'm going to fry these pakoras. Oh yes, it's ready.
Lovely, lovely. Bit more heat?
Yeah. Get me a spoon.
Oh, it's brown already.
As long as you keep an eye on that one.
It's timing then, isn't it?
Yes.
I'll just keep them agitated a wee bit here.
Yes?
One wash plate.
Okay, Alan. Yeah, we need this plate here.
Let's put them.
Will you just take them out one by one? You see that it's crispy when that's all done, yeah?
Okay.
Whenever they are done, because this rice is going to get...
Right. Do you want paper napkins on this? Right, Kamal. One napkin.
Lovely.
Solves the problem.
Yes. Oh, these take them all out.
Getting well done there, aren't they? That wee stove's hot, isn't it?
It is. Now what we are going to do is, see, we are not going to throw that oil away. It's a wee bit too much. So we'll take some out. Try some Tabasco sauce.
It needs something there.
There is Tabasco sauce there or lemon juice there.
You can Tabasco sauce and lemon juice.
Or,
probably.
Yeah, squeeze the lemon. Is it nice? Would you please cut that, cube that fish for me?
Yeah, do you want to cut into just little...
Just small pieces, yeah.
So this is going to be one of these mix it up curry jobs.
Well, we don't have no garlic, we don't have no ginger. So we will just make do with what we have.
What are you doing here?
I just put a bit of turmeric and a bit of chili.
So that's just onions, oil, turmeric and chili?
Uh-huh.
And you forgot the garlic.
Well, I don't have any garlic.
Do we use it all?
Well, in the small shops, you can't get garlic around here. Guess what I have just found?
Garlic.
No, this is garam masala. Garlic. This is garlic. It's called Kashmiri masala. Kashmiri masala is a hot garlic chutney.
From Kashmir?
Smell it. So that'll do the job. What we are doing here is just making the base because fish will not take long to make.
So half the time's cooking the spices and the ingredients that you put in there.
Yeah.
What about that?
Perfect.
Nice there. Presentation for you, Kamal.
Yes. That's very good.
Ah, well. Chili powder. Burn the mouth of me, eh?
Oh yes.
Yeah, do you put chili on everything?
Chili is main ingredient, spice of life. And if you don't believe me, squeeze that lemon on there, yeah? And now you taste your onions and taste the tomatoes, they will taste 10 times better than you have ever tasted them.
Oh, it tastes sour first and then hot.
Well, what do you think?
Very tasty.
Isn't it?
And it's so simple.
Is it spicy enough?
That's plenty spicy enough.
Salt, chili.
There's a really strong taste of that.
Well, that's what we're going to do is...
What did you call the stuff you put in there?
Kashmiri masala.
Kashmiri masala.
The masala means spice.
And each one is the area that it comes from?
Depends, yes.
It comes from different parts of India, different regions of India.
So obviously the Kashmiris like their food hot.
Mm-hmm.
Of course. Now just run me through what you put in this, Kamal.
There was onions. We just browned the onions. Add turmeric, salt, chili, Kashmiri masala, fresh coriander, tomatoes. And let
fish.
It simmer.
Let it simmer
for a
while.
Fish in the end.
Right.
Because you want your sauce ready before you put the fish in, because it's only going to take 2 minutes or 3 minutes to cook it.
Right.
Fish, and especially this type of fish, which is flaky. When you make it into a curry, it always flakes.
And
it
you
breaks.
Don't want it to break up.
And we don't want it to break, so we want it to stay solid, and it will stay solid. It'll only break inside our bellies.
So it's just about ready, eh?
Just give it another couple of minutes.
I'll get a plate or two sorted.
Yeah.
So we got pollack pakoras.
Yeah.
With, what do you call it?
I think I'll call it Donegal Delight Punjabi style.
Very good.
Because it has taken us a whole day.
So why Punjabi style? I thought it was Kashmiri style.
Uh-huh. Spice is called Kashmiri masala. But this is totally traditionally North Indian cooking. It's a Punjabi cooking. That's the way.
Quite spicy.
It's exactly as I like it. I must say,
and you see the fish didn't break, but when you eat it, it'll just melt in your mouth.
It just melts in your mouth, absolutely.
That's the whole idea.
That is absolutely superb. I'm going to get into this curry cooking. La 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 la.
ने बुलाया गले से भी लगाया बहुत समझाया यही ना समझा हसीनों ने बुलाया गले से भी लगाया बहुत समझाया यही ना समझा जमाने भर कन्नाकारा न जाने किस पे आए